zone. Need to find a lease or locate alone. Empowerment is having funds to match the savings you have begun. And good advice after the deal is done.
Here in power, New Haven, combining hope with possibilities. Here in our community, we're making a lasting difference for generations to come. Empowering all, one by one. Business grows as business knows, so the Business Assistance Center will grow. Empowering refreshed ideas from your business community peers, like tax incentives that keep good businesses here. When the next step's not clear to you, give a call back. We can help you there too. Empower, we'll find a way. Let's begin that friendship today. Here in our community, we're making a lasting difference for generations to come. Empowering all, one by one. We're making a lasting difference for generations to come. Empowering all, one by one. Here in our community, we're making a lasting difference for generations to come. Empowering all, one by one. We're in power, New Haven, combining hope with possibilities. Here in our community, we're making a lasting difference for generations to come.
Find a lease or locate a loan. Empowerment is having funds to match the savings you have begun. And good advice after the deal is done.
Here in power, New Haven, combining hope with possibilities. Here in our community, we're making a lasting difference for generations to come. Empowering all, one by one.
Good out to check out in Hamden. And Bishop Wilcox, a lot of you know, he was one of the starters along with Ollie Strings. And some of the meetings at the beginning, they were at Winchester School, they were at Jerry Clark's office, and they were at the Dixon Tool House. The organization got on its feet because these guys got together and said, hey, we're not getting access to capital. Going to the banks, beating their heads at the banks and saying, let's see if we can get together. One, school ourselves so that we're more ready to go to the bank. And also, we can start going in mass, sitting down, talking something that made a little bit of sense. Some of the former presidents of the organization, mostly the West Shore, is runs a shelter on Grand Avenue, Willie Holmes Insurance. He's a former president. Judge Clarence Jones is a former president. Linda Hart is a former president. Jack Foyer, Joe Gray, that has the food service business and all. These guys are all former presidents of the organization. The organization has done an awful lot in loans, business financing, but I would like to save more than $50 million. In fact, the building on the corner of Dix Road and Webster, that is now a church, the organization was very much involved in getting that built. For Hank Green, actually, for his record shop and whatnot. The other building that's now Planned Funeral, the organization was very instrumental in getting that built to SBA. when Lee Jones was involved. A lot of the members of the organization, past members, sit on a lot of boards and commissions throughout the country. One of the things we, some of you that have been to the meetings, know that Gerald Clark advises everybody, please send your forms, and you can send them to put us on boards and commissions. One of the things that Gil Bain was saying, as far as the city construction, the city selected someone to handle construction. That's all decided by boards. Boards and commissions in this country decide just about everything. They handle millions of dollars. Police board, fire department board. So our organization constantly advises people, if you're in whatever town you're in, try to get on a board or commission. And if it's not one of those kind of boards, whether it's the United Way or something, there's always somebody that can be helped by being involved in a board or a commission. The businesses in our association actually do a little bit of everything. But one of the things that we've been fortunate enough to do lately, through Empower Haven, is be involved with the Contractors Construction Assistance Center. And when I'm here looking at all the different resources that have come from that organization, and I didn't even realize some of the organizations that were involved in this Construction Assistance Center. I didn't realize, but I guess I should have, that SCORE was involved. I noticed Dr. McKinney now is involved, which is another resource. I think between the different resources of the organization, the SBI and whatnot, every single thing the contractor needs is here. Between networking, we've got Gil Bain involved, so that's contracts that actually can be gotten, there's training, there's SAMA, who does the computer training. So everything that's needed is here. And we got Empower New Haven now that is the coordinator of all those different services. And I think between our different organizations, we're not in competition with them. SAMA, Business and Professional Association, the Chamber, the SBI, we're supposed to be here to help each other. We can sit down and we need something and we can coordinate it and say, okay, we supply this, they supply that, they do that a little better than we do it, let's sit down and talk to them. Or they may say, we do something a little better than they do, let's talk to them. One of the things our organization has been is we are a nuisance. So when I say a nuisance, Walter was that. Somebody banging on a city door and hadn't been for years. And most of the contractors know that. The other university knows it because there's always some contractor, and you guys go through it in summer and all your organization. Somebody's always coming in business saying, I need such and such a thing. Get this for me. Nobody will return my phone call. So as a result, you have to sort of be a nuisance. Sometimes people hate us, and sometimes we hate other people. But the whole deal is, end up delivering and having that respect. Walt and I have had 100 fights, but I have to respect Walt Esley. He's there, and when I have to send someone down, I say, hey, you gotta see Walt Esley. We've had 100 fights. I have to say, hey, Walt's there, he's gonna help you. Get down and see him. And so we all have to learn to respect each other, and if we can do that, you walk in the door, and one of the questions I always ask is, okay, if I come into business and professional, and I join, what do I get for my money? Or if I come in, what do I get for the time spent? The answer is, what do you need? Every business needs something different. You may need to contact somebody who's at Gil Bain. You walk in the door, we may not have a relationship with it. Maybe Lucy does, Bob Lucy, or maybe Carla does. Maybe Walter. So as a result, we're supposed to get on the phone and call him because maybe we just had an argument with Gil Bain. So as a result, we get on the phone and call him, hey, you know what? Can you talk to Tom Rozier? Because so-and-so wants to talk to him. So the question of the chamber, and I'm on the chamber membership committee, and we constantly talk about is what do we need? It's hard, it's intangible. Someone joins, what is the person given to join the chamber? And the answer has to be, what do they need at the time? You may just need to know somebody that's in Chicago who's getting ready to open up an office building in New Haven, and you want to get involved in it. So you walk in the chamber and say, who do you know? They make a call, and someone else makes a call. And as a result, that part of the need is met at the time. And that's what we all, that's our organization do. It's not, you can't put a handle on what we do. You have to put a handle on what you need and see if we can answer those needs. Our organization has informal networking meetings every Wednesday. like to say 10 o'clock, but actually it's between 11 o'clock and 12 o'clock. We have four network meetings. There's coffee and donuts every Wednesday. So if anybody wants to just stop in for a coffee and donut, we're there. And a lot of interesting people on that there. Actually, Bill Bain has been there and made a presentation to Yale University has been there plenty of times. University of Connecticut came out and made a presentation on their construction and what can be done there. Same thing with Fusco, they've been to an awful lot of organizations around that are really the power breakers. Usually we can get them in the door if somebody wants to talk to them. Normally we try to set up those kind of things. So I'm kind of glad to be here. I'm awfully glad, we're glad as an organization to be involved in the Power Behavior Contracting Assistance Center. And I'm glad now to find out all the different partners that are in, so that sometime I can pick up the phone and you don't feel so lonely. You say, hey, let me call so-and-so and see if we can get some help from them. If somebody walked in their door, we need to talk to them. And also, if someone walks in our door, we can also pick up the phone and refer them to them. Any questions?
Do you have a resource center for contractors?
And the resource center is open every Monday through Thursday from 9 until 7 at night, and on Friday from 9 until 5 o'clock.
Well, when you say resource center, what are we talking about?
We're talking about we have access to computer, we have access to internet, we also have access to information, and also we can network with people. And we also have access to business plan. You got something about it?
No, that was my question.
Location?
Oh, sorry. Location is 192 Dixon Avenue, right? It's a plaza. And the sun is there every day, from 9 o'clock in the morning.
The only services are free?
Yes.
partnership with the certified minority business community. So we've got two groups that we work with, primarily large businesses and minority businesses. And our mission is to bring those groups together. We have a number of activities and events that are designed to do that. We don't guarantee businesses that they're going to get business. The only thing that we can guarantee is that we're going to put you in the room so that you can make your case to do business with the corporate community. And perhaps more importantly, for small businesses, your best opportunity is probably with other businesses or the other owners or owners of other businesses. And so right now in the CMSDC, we have about 120 corporate members, and they include many of the well-known companies in the state. You're probably very familiar with companies like Xerox and Pitco and UTC and GE and the Hartford, et cetera. And those are the businesses who are the members of the organization. We work with them to help them identify minority businesses to do business. The other group, the certified minority businesses, we have about 300 certified minority businesses. And they range from startups, which means they don't have any sales, to companies that are doing close to $1 billion in business. So we have very small businesses, and we have very relatively large small businesses. And we do a number of things to help both the corporate members and the MDs. For instance, this month, in fact, or next month, July, we'll be sending a number of our business owners to do some more continuing education, executive education. We have a relationship with one of the best business schools, in fact, the oldest business school in the country is at Dartmouth College. We will pay for half of that business owner's tuition to go to Dartmouth. This year, we also have a program where it's not our program, but again, we support business owners who want to develop their businesses and to develop their executive abilities. So there's a program in Chicago that's going to take place next month, and it's on doing business with China. Now, you may not want to do business with China, but we have a number of businesses that do want to do business with China. Either they import things from them or to source things from China. And so we will pay for our business owners to go to that seminar to learn how to do business in China. As you know, the world is changing. Your industry is changing. And if you're in business, you have to stay competitive, which means you have to change too. So there's no sort of set way of doing business that works forever. You have to be flexible. So we have events and activities upcoming. We have a trade show that takes place over at Foxwoods in September. And that's a program where our business, our minority businesses, and our corporate members will exhibit to share information about what they do and how they do it. That's our biggest event. We have a number of other activities and events. This week, in fact, we're going to be at the GE Capital in Danbury. You're welcome to join us if you like, where we're going to be talking about helping a business identify other businesses that they can buy. Because in business, it's been my experience that you either get big or you die. And so you have to figure out a way to supply more services and do it profitably in order to survive. Because at the end of the day, you're in business because you want to put money in your pocket. And so to put more money in your pocket, you have to grow. And growing one customer at a time is fine, but growing at 50 customers at a time is better. And so we are encouraging our MBEs to consider acquisitions, particularly of non-MBE companies. So it's not written somewhere that minority businesses have to stay small, or minority businesses can only do business with minority businesses. Business is business. And so the CMSDC is about trying to help our businesses acquire businesses, get big, become profitable, become relevant in the business world. Now, in construction, we have some other activities that are taking place that will be more perhaps relevant to you. We had, and one you missed, some of you may have missed, we had a program up at the Northeast Utilities on May 24th, where it was the Minority Construction Expo. We had over 40 booth exhibitors there, including some of the larger construction contractors and also owners of construction projects in the state of Connecticut that attended that event. And again, the purpose of that event was to share information about opportunities, but also to make those connections between minority businesses and other businesses. There's a new initiative that we're working on with Empowering Haven. They have the ink. I can't even say the ink is dry because there's no ink. Yeah. So it's in the mail. But we're working on something.
We are in agreement.
We're in agreement. So we're in agreement, and the essentially the agreement is CMSBC wants to supply back office services for small construction companies. And the intention of this program really is to take essentially some of the necessary work that has to be done to grow a business, to share that work with you. In some cases, take that work off your plate and put it on our plate so that we can do it and you can do what's best then for your business, which is to provide the goods and services to your customers. This is a sort of an incubator model where the council will serve as an incubator for early stage minority construction companies. What we will do is we will help you with the responses to RFPs, the marketing, some of the technology, some of the payroll, some of the banking, some of the other services that we might be able to do more efficiently if we have a group of smaller businesses working with us. We're not taking your business away from you. You only give us what you want to give us. But that's essentially the approach, and we hope to roll that out before the end of the year. The council would welcome you guys as certified minority businesses. There is a process to become certified in our organization. At Carissa Allen's company is certified in the council. And that process is essentially an application, a site visit. And there is a fee, but I'm sure that we can work on that with the help of Empowerment Haven. Because we want you guys to participate. We want to get your information and you in front of potential customers to do business with. Just recently, last week, the National Association of Minority Contractors had their annual convention down in Orlando. We sent one of our consultants down to that program and to get information about what's going on nationally that we need to be aware of. So one of the things that we're talking to them about is actually setting up an office here. There's no office of the National Association of Minority Contractors here in Connecticut. So we're talking to them about essentially hosting that office. Another national program that we're involved in, the Connecticut Minority Supplier Development Council, is part of the National Minority Supplier Development Council. So we've got 39 regional councils like the Connecticut Council. In 2008, we are, as an organization, looking at putting together a national program on minorities in the construction industry. And it's my belief, and it's the belief of many others in our network, that minority businesses are not participating as fully as they should in the opportunities in the construction industry. This is a multi-trillion-dollar industry, but the minority businesses are not getting essentially their share of the work. And there are a lot of reasons for that. And it's a double-edged sword. Some of the reasons are on your plate. Some of the reasons are on the rest of the major contractors and owners of those projects. And we have to really work to close the gap so that minority businesses can get more of that work. So there's a lot going on in the council. I welcome you to participate in our program, to join our organization. I have some business cards. We have a website. We work very closely with Empowerment Haven and the Greater Haven Chamber of Commerce and other organizations. And I think you will get a lot out of it. Well, I'll tell you this much. You'll get out of what you put in. If you get a certificate from us and you're hanging on the wall and you don't participate, nothing's gonna happen. I can guarantee you, nothing will happen. But if you get certified by our council and you come into activities and events and you ask us for assistance and help, and I'm not saying we will solve all your problems either. We will help. We will try to help you solve your problems. But it's your business that, and you're responsible. You guys, unless you want to share meeting your partner or something, you don't consider that. But it's your business, and you're responsible for the bottom line of your business. But we can help you. I'm convinced of that. We can help you. If nothing else, we can give you somebody to talk to about what's going on in your business, what's going on with your customers, perhaps identify some other customers for you, perhaps also identify some other companies that you can work with. So those are the types of things that we do. I'm going to switch gears now and talk a little bit about the Department of Administrative Services. And let me first say, I am not a state employee.
Okay.
The Connecticut Arts Fire Development Council is a private not-for-profit organization. I was asked by Bob to come and talk a little bit about the state Connecticut program and talk about it based on what I know about the program. And so, you know, what I say, that's my disclaimer. There may be some differences between what I say and what the program actually is. But I have some experience with the Department of Administrative Services, small and minority business program. It is a small business program, primarily. State of Connecticut has as a goal to do 25% of its contracting with small businesses. The small and minority business program is part of that small business effort. So within that 25%, the state of Connecticut says 25% of that should go to minority and women-owned small businesses. So 25% of 25% is 6.25%. Okay? So 6.25% of state contracts are supposed to go to minority and women-owned small businesses. They define small businesses as roughly businesses only less than $10 million a year. So if you are not certified with the state of Connecticut, now their certification doesn't cost you anything but your time. So they have a program. Their program is all on the website. If you Google State of Connecticut Department of Administrative Services, the Small and Minority Business Program is an application. You should get your information in their system. You should basically in their system that you can tell them what you do. And when things come up that are identified as small and minority business contracts, they're supposed to get that information out to the companies that are signed up in that area. So that is the state of Connecticut is the largest contracting organization in the state of Connecticut, public or private, they're the biggest. So you should enroll in their certification. Now again, that is not, again, there's no guarantees in getting contracts with the state by just being certified. You have to work the system. You have to talk to the contracting meetings. You have to actually respond to RFPs. That's one of the things that, going back to what we said earlier, with what the council wants to do, which is to provide those sorts of technical services for small businesses. Because let's face it, if you're on a roof doing a roof job, you don't have time to respond to an RFP for another roof job. And that's the problem that we've seen with minority businesses in construction. You can do the work, but to be successful in business, it's more than just being able to do the work. It's about growing the business, which means you have to have things in the pipeline. You constantly have to be working on new customers. Somebody has to be marketing your business all the time. And if you're a small business and you're wearing all these hats, you can't do all that. Or you can't do it well. You may try to do it. Or you may, you know, maybe you're tired to do it. And so, you know, if you look at the industry that you're in, and I assume that you guys are in the construction industry, you look at the industry that you're in, if you go to Turner, there are people whose only job there is to review RFPs. There are people whose only job there is legal. There are people whose only job there is payroll. There are people whose only job there is marketing. So if you don't have the resources to do that, you got to figure out another way. And that's what I think the council can do to help you. Now, we're not cure-all, but I think we can help you when we're offering our assistance. I'd be happy to entertain some questions, some comments, or anything of that nature. Yes, sir.
When you mentioned about the bidding process that you can, your office will be doing, so if John Doe had a roofing company, let's say, he would find out about the possibility of a contract or your services to find out about that.
Well, it kind of depends on how much money you hire and pay to give us.
Okay.
So the one model would be, we could, there are services that you can subscribe to that share with the subscriber what contracts are coming down the pipe. And if you have those services, if you pay for that service, and you have a list of contractors who are participating in that program, then as things come down, you can identify opportunities for the MWBEs in this program, and so basically say, you know, there's something coming up in Bristol. Would you be interested in looking at this? Well, some of the things that, you know, of course, time is the issue, right? When am I going to have time to go to Bristol, to do the walkthrough, to listen to understand who those primes are, to understand who I'm going to be working with, to estimate the job, to do all of that work while I'm working on the job? And that's the problem that many contractors have, is they have to do jobs one at a time. And if you do jobs one at a time, then you are limiting your growth. You can't grow. You have to have multiple jobs that either you can do or partner with others to do. Any other comments, questions? What business is this, for my information? I know Flo and Greg. What business is this?
Finding hope and possibilities. Here in our community, we're making a lasting difference for generations to come. Empowering all, one by one. Let's all, you're in the zone. Don't try to work this system alone.
For me and my three children, I'm a single parent, and I felt that the program would benefit me and my children. I filled out the application and I got the information back that I was approved, which I was very happy about. The program is very good and beneficial to people who don't have the money right away to get a house. So you have to save for the house. You basically open up a savings account through three banks. They give you to choose from. I chose People's Bank because I go to People's. And you have to put a minimum of $20 in the bank per month, or as much as you would like. You can't go over $345 a month. So $20, you spend $20 a week on getting breakfast and lunch at work. So it's really not that much money. You're not really hurting your pockets too bad by putting $20 aside to get a house. So I've been doing that, and I successfully have finished saving my money. So now I'm on the next step in the program, which will be to go to neighborhood housing to start the next step, which would be to purchase a home. You have to take an 8-hour class there. So Haven Saves is a very good program. Everyone there at Empire and Haven is very nice. We have buddy groups, which we meet once a month. And the buddy groups are actually very good. Everyone brings to the table different information, whether it be coupons at stores to save us money or gas coupons, anything just to basically help us save the money to strive to get to our goal, which is to be a first-time home buyer. And we meet once a month, I think I said that, right? What else? Okay. The program also within the agencies, they actually match 2-for-1. So if you save 2 for every dollar. The program also within the agencies, they actually match 2-for-1. So if you save 2 for every dollar. So Empowering Haven actually, we save $2,000 and they actually match that and they give us 4. So we have a total of 6 when it comes down to clothing costs for your house or any other thing that will come up at the end once you're ready to purchase your home. So that's a blessing in itself. I would have $6,000 just to give up for a clothing of a house. So that's good. And it's nothing bad I can say about the program. It's very beneficial. And the program may not be, if anyone is interested in becoming a first-time home buyer and not exactly ready at the moment financially, the Empire New Haven, the New Haven Saves program is a very good program. The contact person there is Jacana Falwell. She'll let you know when they're taking applications for the program. And if it's not for you, it may be for someone in your family, someone you may know of that needs a little help in getting getting help to purchase a home as being a first-time home buyer. So I would, it's a great opportunity, so I would let family and friends know that getting a little help with your goals, because you also can start a small business with the money. They do the same thing, they match it by 2. Or you also, it's a small business and you also can go to college. So if you have family members that have older children that want to go into college after they finish high school, they also do the same thing. So they will have $6,000 to help them with college. So it's for 3 different things that I'm sure someone out there would know someone who needs a little extra help with getting monies for these 3 things. And Jacana Sowell is the contact person there. And you have to be eligible. You do have to be eligible within the income guidelines. So they'll be able to tell you if you are by you submitting your pay stubs and your W-2s. They would be able to let you know if you qualify for the program or not. Okay, and another part of the program would be attending Credit Smart, which helped me with the budgeting in order to even be ready for the program. Basically, they give you a budget and you have to fill out a form in order of your monthly expenses, how much money you spend, you know, per month. So that was very beneficial to me. I didn't even realize how much money I waste weekly on eating out and taking the kids to the movies and Daddy Extreme, just unnecessary things that I was spending money on, which, you know, I didn't even have to do buying clothes every week and getting the kids new sneakers. Just, you know, let them wear the sneakers down a little bit before you go out and purchase new ones. So I really learned a lot through Credit Smart, and I actually budgeted, and I was able to be plus every month on my budgeting sheet. I was over because I cut out a lot of unnecessary spending of monies. And I'm sure everyone does it day to day. You may not realize it until you sit down to do a budget, but Credit Smart was excellent in really revealing to me that how much money that I spend every week unnecessarily. $100, that could be towards, you know, purchasing a house, you know. So that part of the program was great for me and for my family. My children now are, they like to budget too. Oh, wow, are we gonna do that? You know, I still, you know, I'm not 100% at it, but I'm much better than what I was. Cause sometimes, you know, you wanna splurge a little bit, but I never go over the boundaries a little. If I save an extra 100, I may take 20, you know, 25 and do something out of that. But I have been able to save plus $200 to $300 per month in using my budget and staying exactly with my budget. And I would have never done that. I would have been scraping to save the money if I didn't have that budgeting part of the Credit Smart program. So it has helped me and my children to realize the value of, you know, of saving money to get, you know, to get our goal, because everyone wants a house. That's, you know, they want a backyard, they want a, you know, they want a house. So they're even helping out too, and that's and also in the program they do offer direct deposit. So if you're easy tempted and you just want to have the money automatically taken out of your checking account, you also can fill out the paperwork for that, and you wouldn't even see the money. Basically, they'll just take it right out your account every week, and you would tell them how much money you want them to take. You can do the minimum of the 20 per week, or you can do more. You actually can save more than $2,000 in your account. It depends on you and what you want to have set aside for the end of the process when it's time to close. So some people will end up with over $2,000, you know, $2,000 in the bank. But Empower New Haven will only give you the $4,000. So, but you can save over, and that's also a good thing. You might want to buy little things when you get in your new home, you know, so it's extra money you can stay still in the bank. So that's a good thing to know too. So you can do the direct deposit, or you also can just do, basically when you go to make, you can go make deposits to the bank. And I find that was an easier way for me to do it once I do my budget, which I do it every month. So it's easy for me to, whatever dollar amount I'm over, it's easier for me to just take that over amount and put into the bank, as opposed to doing it direct deposit. Because some months I'm over a little more than it varies. It depends on, sometimes I have to go into my little emergency fund sometimes, so sometimes I'm over a little bit. So that works out for me better than direct deposit, but it's whatever is better for you. But direct deposit is an option to take advantage of also when you go to apply for the program at Empower New Haven. In general, and also with the Credit Smart, it also is good behavior to continue, not only through this program, but in life. It's a good thing to do, to continuously save. So whatever my next thing I would need to do, whatever I may choose to do next, I know what I can do it just by budgeting and saving money, and actually getting my whole family, my three children as well, involved, as you know, and they're very young. They're only 9, 6, and 4, and I'm starting them already, so it can benefit them as they get, you know, older, that you can't waste money. And the program is also federally funded, so in order, you know, it's not going to be around forever, so it's a good idea to call Empower New Haven and ask for Jacana and find out when they will be taking applications for the next session. There are a limited amount of people that they will choose to participate in the program. So it's a good idea to just call to find out when the next session is and be one of the first people to apply for the program. And just let people know, your family and friends, know if it's in, you know, if they're interested in being a first-time homebuyer or children going to college. And also, if you want to open up a small business, you can also receive the $6,000, which would help you to start off your small business, going to college, or closing costs for your first-time homebuyers. And also, if you're not ready to purchase a home, but know that's something that you want to do, they actually, in the program, give you up to 3 years to save your monies. And also, because some people have to fix their credit as well. So some people are not going to be ready to just jump right into purchasing a home or going to school or opening up a small business right away. So you have 3 years to get your budget in order, to actually save. And as the money is sitting, regardless of how much is in the bank, you're gaining interest on that also for up into the 3 years. So you're actually going to have a little bit extra money from interest as well, depending upon how long you actually leave the money in the bank. But you have 3 years, which is enough time to get your monies in order and to get yourself and family ready to go to the next level. And everyone could be chipping in. If you have older kids, they can be chipping in also to help you toward getting your goal. I do have my 3 kids as well helping. They save their little monies, and I have this money to put, you know, towards a house for our big backyard. So we actually are doing it all together, even though they're little, but I'm training them while they're little, so when they grow up, they'll have, you know, some sense of, you know, what a dollar is, because they don't know what it is right now. They're starting to learn by me teaching them learning from Credit Smart. So you have 3 years to get everything in order, and Empower New Haven will hold onto the money until then. But once your 3 years is up, you actually need to make a decision at what you're going to use the money for. Some people don't know right away when they first go into the program what they want to do. They're undecided. As long as, you know, you're starting to save for something, you don't really even have to know which, you know, what you're saving for. Some people do know what they want their money to go towards, and some people don't. But once the 3 years come when it's over, you need to know what you're going to do and basically use the monies, the $4,000, as well as your 2 for a total of 6 to do one of the 3 things. So you have time, and if you need to fix your credit, you also can go through credit counseling and fix your credit in the meanwhile. You're still saving, and you can be fixing your credit, and then once you fix your credit, you will be mortgage ready, or whichever 3 of the programs you decide to go with, you'll be ready to start. So it is very good that they give you that time in order to get yourself together and prepare to use the monies. The 3 years is a long enough time where you should be all set to make your decision on what you want to do. Take advantage of the program, and if it's not for you, let someone else know about the program and call Empower New Haven and find out where they're taking applications. If you want a small business, if you want to be a first-time home buyer, or if your children want to go to college, or you can actually go to college as well, take advantage of the program. It's very beneficial, and it's a help to those who need the help.
here in our community. We're making a lasting difference for generations to come. Empowering all, one by one. Vent for all, you're in the zone. Need to find at least one location alone. Empowerment is having funds to match the savings you have begun. And good advice after the deal is done. Here in power, New Haven, combining hope with possibilities. Here in our community, we're making a lasting difference for generations to come. Empowering all, one by one. Business grows as business knows, so the business assistance sector will grow. Empowering your fresh ideas from your business community peers, like tax incentives that keep good businesses here. When the next step's not clear to you, give a call.